Welcome again to the continuation of the topic, permutation. What are the other principles of permutation? And we have the eighth principle now to discuss. Number of permutation of n different objects, if similar, all of them must not be together, is given by the formula. Number of n objects without r and number of combination of their different positions. What do you mean by this? How many ways can a letter of the word spoon be arranged if two O's must not be together? Then, from this, what do we mean by number of n objects without R? See what we mean. If you remove these two O's, how many letters will remain? 1, 2, 3 letters. You see, you now say that number of n objects without R. Number of any object without R equals how many letters do we have when you remove the one that they say must not be together? We have 3. You say 3 factorial equal to 3 times 2 times 1 equal to 6. Then what do we mean by number of combinations of their different positions? See what we mean. We mean that these two O will be taken once. You will be having S-P-O-N. That will be 4 letters instead of 5. You take these two O's once. That will be 4 letters combination. How many letters must not be together? 2. That will be 4 factorial all over. Now, 4 combination 2 will be 4 factorial all over 2 factorial. Then 4 minus 2. 2 factorial. That will be giving us 4 times 3 times 2 factorial. All over 2 factorial times 2 factorial. This will cancel this. Then 2 factorial is 2. 2 here, 2 here, 2. 2 times this, 6 ways. You now tell them that the final number of ways we multiply the 2. 6 times 6 will give you a total of 36 ways. That is the final answer. 36 ways. Now in this question, in how many ways must the letters of the word occur for bearing if two O must not be together? You say number of n object, number of permutation of n object, number of permutation. Number of permutation of n. Number of permutation of n object without R. When you remove these two O, what will remain? K-A-F-R. Therefore, you say 4 factorials. 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. 4 times 3, 12 times 2, 24 ways. Now, for number of combination of their different positions, it means call these two O, 1 O. It will be O-K-A-F-R. Now, these two O is taken to be 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That will be giving you 5 combination 2. Equal to 5 factorial all over 2 factorial. 5 minus 2, 3 factorial. That will be giving us 5 times 4 times 3 factorial all over 2 factorial, 3 factorial. This will cancel the 2 factorial 2. 2 times this, 2. 2 times 5. 10 ways. Now, total number of ways will be 24 times 10 equal to 240 ways. Now, while permutation with restriction, more of them is what we want to discuss. From the list of 1, 0, 3, 5, 2, 4, 6, how many number each having 5 distinct digits, the last which must be 0, be formed? If they give you this type of question, what you do is that you say, okay, let it be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 0. The last is 0. So, we are trying to see how to do this. If they ask you to do that, use the formula n minus 1 permutation r minus 1. N is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 minus 1 permutation 7 minus 1 permutation When I say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 minus 1. Now they say from the list of this, how many numbers each having 5 distinct digits? The last. So we are trying to form five distinct digits. So first thing you do is that you take note of how many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You tell them that n is equal to 7. Then tell them that since they say the last must be 0, you keep 0 aside. Whatever you permute here will be having this 0. That is the meaning. Then the implication is that 7 minus 1 all over 5, which is the R, 5 minus 1. That will be giving you 6 permutation 4. That will be giving you 6 factorial all over 6 minus 4, 2 factorial. We give you 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 factorial all over 2 factorial. This we can do it. 6 times 5, 30 times 4, 1 to 1 times 3, 360 ways. Now see the next question. How many ways can four digit number be made from the integers this? If the integers are used once, if the integers are used once, what you tell them is that, okay, do we have anyone that repeat more than once? No. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I will now say, n is equal to 6. How many am I forming? 4. And r equal to 4. So, how many ways can 4 be made from this? So, what I will say is 6 permutation 4. So, what do we have? 6 factorial all of. Remember, it's because there is no repetition. No? You now say 4 minus 4, 6 minus 4, 2 factorial. 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 all over 2 times 1. That is mean of 2 factorial. This we cancel this. That would be 360 ways. Now, the B part, if the 4 digits are repeated. So, in arranging 4 or in arranging 4 digits from this, you say if they should be repeated, use the formula n raised to the power of r, where n equal to 6, r equal to 4. That is the one we are forming. Why are we using this formula? This is a shortcut to get how many ways 4-digit number can be made if the 4-digit numbers are repeated. What is our n? 6 raised to the power of 4. 6 times 6 times 6 times 6. 6 times 6 times 6 times 6 times 6, 216 times 6. That will be giving you 1296 ways. Oh, that is how we call it a day on this permutation. Next video, we'll talk on combination. Okay? Thanks for watching the video. Please don't forget to click subscribe and like button as you enjoy the video. See you in the next class. Thank you.